All right, 9:24 right now. We're talking cybersecurity this Wednesday morning. It is a big issue, obviously, and if you don't think it affects you, you may want to be thinking again, especially by the end of this segment. Joining us to talk about it, Director of Treasury and Payment Solutions Sales at Webster Bank, Larry Selnick for Connecticut Businesses. Nice to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
I got to tell you, we were talking before the break,
yes.
And I know we're not talking about personal stuff, but you know, business-wise, I just checked my email. And 10 minutes ago, I received an email from my bank saying I had some suspicious activity and I need to log on to this website and fix it. And I'm smart enough to go, wait a second, that email doesn't look right. And sure enough, it was fake. It was a phishing scam. This is happening a lot, isn't it?
Happens a lot. Happens a lot in businesses. Social engineering, they're taking advantage of the fact that people, honest people, are trying to do the right thing. So they get an email. It looks like their boss. It looks like the president of the company.
Had a logo,
has everything right.
And everything. Yeah.
And it says, send some money because I'm doing something. Don't tell anybody.
Right.
Or send me a file of all the payrolls because I'm doing something. And so you're either sending money inadvertently or you're giving away information.
Here's the thing, and especially, and I'm not a business owner, but you know, I'm just watching over my own personal accounts. If you're running your own business, everything gets magnified and the numbers get bigger, and I would suspect the dangers get larger as well.
So what happens is businesses, especially small businesses, don't realize they're a target.
Yeah.
They're being looked at, they're being viewed. They probably have software already in their systems. They don't even know that that's watching them.
Right.
And so people have to be very vigilant and realize, first off, they are going to be targeted. Mm-hmm. It's probably going to happen, and they really need to ask themselves
a
question.
You're not talking about an if. You're saying a when, and that's troubling to me.
It's not even if, it's not when. It's a matter of how much it's going to cost to recover. And that's the hidden cost.
Yeah.
You may send money out that you didn't want to send, but worse, you might send information you shouldn't send out there. Mm-hmm. Now you have to recover from it. And if you haven't planned for that, think about your business. You know that what you're going to do if you lose power. You know what you're going to do if you have a fire. Do you know what you're going to do if someone says all of your data is frozen?
Which is more likely to happen
or
than a fire.
We've stolen or all your data?
Yeah. Let me read it. I want to get the statistic absolutely correct. 60% of small businesses that suffer a cyber attack go out of business in 6 months? Is that true?
It's reputation risk. It's the cost to recover. It's trying to figure out what to do after the fact.
Uh-huh.
So now you've got to tell your customers, you have to tell your employees, you have to tell your vendors, whoever your partners are, I can't do business with you today. I can't pay you today. I gave away your credit card information or your Social Security information. You can destroy your business by not being ready for this.
So tell me quickly, what's the one thing I need to know if I'm running a small business?
Train your employees, train yourself, be aware that it can be real. Talk to your insurance, your lawyers, your accountants, your bankers. We can help you with information and things you can do. I tell people, go to our website, Google fraud awareness checklist, download it, read it, and ask yourself, do I do all these things? And if I don't, maybe I need to start
otherwise,
doing some of them.
Larry said it's almost like leaving the back door unlocked to your business. And we could talk about this for hours.
For hours.
Because it is going to be affecting a lot of you, and it is getting stronger, and you got to be smarter. Nice to see you.
Thank you very
Thanks
much for having me.